I've got a present in here for my friend, so I'm not going to show you that. Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I thought I'd film a bit of a haul. I realise it is definitely the season that we're supposed to be giving to other people, but I've realised over the past 6 weeks-ish, I've actually picked up quite a few things, so I thought I would film them for you. It's a big old collective haul. Boots happened, Space NK happened, I went to Cardiff, so Illamasqua happened. So yeah, I just thought I'd share what I've got with you, and yeah. Let's start with boots. This is actually several trips. First of all, I'm going to show you these clips. Obviously, they come in a pack of two. These are Trevor Sorbie clips, and if you can see, they're sort of like a bit more fancy than your usual one. Although these clips are, it's like £4 something for two, which is a lot of money. But normal clips, just like normal ones, are about the same price, but maybe you get an extra one. So I thought, hey, I'll invest, and I might pick up a couple more packs of these as well. But yeah, they're just a bit more fancy clips. As you'll see in my boots haul, it's actually quite a lot of hair stuff because I'm going to be re-ombreing my hair. I was re-watching some of my videos because I'm collating my best of 2014 beauty products. And I think in March, my March favourites, my hair looked really nice. And I was like, my hair looks really nice. And I think it's because I'd recently re-ombreed it, and I haven't done it for a while. I thought I'd try the Bleach London sort of one. They've got like a dip dye one, which is really like, pff, which I don't do. This one's a bit more sort of like a highlighting kit type thing, for balayage or ombre, as you may well know it. So yeah, I'm probably gonna do a blog post all about this whilst I dye it and what I think of it. So stay tuned for that. I also thought I would pick up their hair mask as well. So why not try it too? And it says it's specifically for coloured hair. And I think it comes in pretty cool packaging. It's sort of like in a metal thing. And this was £6 and it's like pretty big. I shall let you know how I get on with both those. I'll probably whack them in the same blog post, if I'm honest. Oh, last hair thing. I also got another one of my shampoos. This is the Lee Stafford Big Fat Healthy Hair Shampoo, and I really like it, and I'd ran out of sort of all my normal shampoos. I've got quite a lot of conditioner still, so I thought I would pick just one of these up, sort of tide me over before I try something else. Another staple that I've picked up is the Nivea In Shower Body Moisturiser. I'm going to leave my blog post about this all below. This I use every time I shower, so I love it. It's the best. It's really no fuss, and I'm really lazy with moisturising my skin, so I do it in the shower and it's all done, it's all sorted. So yeah, I picked up another one of those. I've also got a bit of makeup. I picked up the La Palette Nude by L'Oreal. This is in the shade Rose, which I believe is the only shade which is available currently. It's a £10 eyeshadow palette, which I will be talking about shortly on my blog, I think. I haven't had that much time with it, but yeah, it's a £10 eyeshadow palette, and they're sort of more purpley colours, so yeah, and I think it's quite nice. I picked up some Yes to Cucumber face wipes. Now, I'm not a big fan of face wipes, but I picked these up because I had a small pack of these, and I took them on a plane with me when I went to Las Vegas, and I just found them really easy, and they weren't like that horrible on my skin, and they were just easy rather than getting like a pad out and some bioderma on the plane to just like keep my face nice and clean, because I'm a bit funny about recycled air, mainly because I think it's a bit worth. I picked a big pack of them up for when I'm on the plane to and from New Jersey in January, so I got those too. And yeah, that's everything from boots. I'm gonna pop it all back in. Next up, I thought I'd quickly stop over at Lush. I picked up one bubble bar. This is Brightside. Hang on, I'll open it up. I've been having a lot more baths. I've been having a lot more baths recently, and so I thought, I actually went into Lush to pick up their soap. They've got one which is like the bunny one, which I think is only in Lush kitchen stores, and there's not one near me, unfortunately, which is like about fighting animal testing. So I thought I'd pick that up, but I couldn't. So whilst I was in there, I thought, well, I'll pick up this. This is the Brightside, which is a pretty big one, and I reckon I'll get about 5 baths out of it, and it smells like orange. I just thought it was like really refreshing, and I'm not one of those people who's crazy on sort of those spicy cinnamon winter scents. So I thought this one would be a bit different from sort of what you're smelling at this time of year, and I liked it, you know? It smells like orange sherbet, so yeah, I picked that up, and it's quite big. It's like more one of the more expensive ones, but I'm definitely not gonna use this in just one bath. I had a House of Fraser voucher to use, so I hopped over to the Dior counter and I picked up the Dior Star Foundation. I'm using the shade 10 and it's actually, show you my face. It's actually what I've got on my skin right now. And so far so good. I've only had it about a week and a half, so I probably won't be reviewing it just yet. But what I will say is, as I said, so far so good. Yeah, it's like kind of got like a creamy texture almost. So it's similar to a, it's more fluid than a tinted moisturiser, but it's still got a creamy element to it, which I think I'm quite enjoying. And yeah, it's just nice. I will definitely be reviewing this and giving you a more in-depth opinion of it once I've had it for a little bit longer. I hopped over to Cardiff last week and in their Debenhams they have an Illamasqua counter, which there isn't one in Bristol. So I picked up the Hollow Pigment, which I've heard very good things about contouring for light skins, and I thought I don't have any cream contour products, so I picked it up and I will let you know how I got on with it. I also think it would be a really nice sort of eyeshadow, sort of not, I don't want to say like grungy or anything. Instead of using my MAC Painterly paint pot, I think this would be quite nice on the eyes too. So I will let you know what I think about this. This is actually my only second product from Illamasqua, so I'm excited. In recent weeks, I have not done one but two cult beauty orders. I love me some cult beauty. So I'm going to go with order number one. I picked up this sort of trial kit from Mio, which are a body brand, which I've been wanting to try. It's got a body oil, a small body butter, and an exfoliator. I just really wanted to try the brand because I had heard really good things about it, and I thought this set would be pretty cute. It wasn't the cheapest. But I think the sample sizes are pretty good sizes, so I will let you know how I get on with this set. Also in that order, I picked up my favourite face mask, which I just ran out of, which is the Aesop Chamomile Concentrate Mask. Now this one, it's £33, which is a lot for a mask, but the reason that I didn't have it for maybe 2 weeks and I was like, no, I need to get it again. This has lasted me since the beginning of the year. Like, I would say this has lasted me 9 months. It'd be even longer than that. This almost lasted me a year, basically, this face mask. So I'm happy to spend £33 a year on a really good face mask. This is really well suited to my skin. My skin likes it. I have oily combo, fairly blemish prone skin. I probably use this once a week or once a fortnight, sort of in between that, maybe once every 10 days. And I didn't have it for 2 weeks and I broke out. So I haven't tried the parsley seed one. I was this close to picking up the parsley seed one instead of this to try something new. I've got quite a few clarifying masks as it is at the moment, so I thought I'd wait until I finish another one of those before I picked it up. But yes, this is very nice. And last but not least, in order number one, we have got order number two coming up. So I picked up a Konjac Sponge. This isn't the plain one, this is like the one for oily skin with charcoal in it. At the moment it's quite small, but you get it wet and it gets a bit bigger and a bit squidgier. These type of sponges have been all over the blogosphere at the minute, so once I've hit a month with this, I'm gonna do a little blog post. And for order number two, I went all out Anastasia, however you want to pronounce it. The contour kit, which has been out of stock for God knows how long, came back into stock and I was on the mailing list and it just popped up into my inbox and I thought I'd better grab it whilst I still can. Now, one thing I want to say about this is, I don't know why, I always thought it looks bigger than what it is. Like, I'm gonna hold it up to my face. Like, I feel like it looks like absolutely massive and it's not, which I'm not saying is a bad thing. I'm just saying it's a observation type thing. The pans in this, I would say they're smaller than MAC blushes. I would say, like, look, here's my finger. That's probably not gonna help. This is definitely something else that I'm gonna be reviewing. I have used it for the first time today because it only came yesterday. And I used these four, I think. They're very pigmented though, so you have to sort of only lightly tap your brush in because otherwise you'll have like a big old stripe on your face. But they are very blendable, so if you do end up with a big old stripe on your face, I'm pretty sure you can blend it out. Anyway, I don't know whether it's still going on or not, but Cult Beauty had a discount code. If you spent over a certain amount of money, you could get, I think, £5 off. And this, of course, everyone, they knew you were gonna go grab for this, so you had to buy something else to get the discount. And so I picked up the Dip Brow Pomade in Medium Brown. I've also got this on my brows today. They are looking a bit in your face today, I think, but I think that's more user error than the product because it's the first time I've used it. But yeah, it's like a little pot and yeah, I can't complain. I literally put my makeup on a couple hours ago and my brows are still there. They're not halfway down my face. So far so good. But yeah, so I picked that up and I got the shade Medium Brown, which I don't know whether or not it's a smidgen too dark. Like, I think I can work with it, but it's darker than my other brow products, so maybe go a shade lighter? I don't know. Now, I know you're not supposed to buy Christmas presents for yourself, but my first Christmas present from me to me was the NARS Lip Coffret. Where's the word coffret come from in the beauty world? Because a lot of brands have got coffrets out at the moment. What is it? It sounds like coffin to me. Anyway, this, I have popped up a review of this already. So I'll link that down below because I've had this quite a while. Of course, one's missing. Hang on. Oh, I used to, where is it? Oh, come with me to Canso. Basically what this set is three lip pencils. They are slightly smaller than your standard ones. I think these are 3/4 of the size. So for the price of less than 2, you get almost 4, which I think, like, quantity-wise, that's fantastic. What you get is you get 2 sort of nudes. You get a bright pink, a sort of orange-based red, and a deep red. As I said, I've put a review up of these already, but spoiler alert, I think this is fantastic. If you get anything from any Christmas range at all, I think you should be getting this. Speaking of NARS launches, I was having a really crappy day and my boyfriend surprised me, like seriously surprised me, with getting me the NARS palette. I was firmly surprised that he got me this, so thank you very much, Matt. But yeah, this is a 5-pan cheek palette which has 1 bronzer, 1 highlighter and 3 blushes. I have Sex Fantasy, on my cheeks today, which is this one here, which is a light dusky pink. And yeah, I can't say good enough things about this. Again, gram for gram, this is a really good value palette as well. So these two, everything else is sort of not seasonal, but the two NARS things, I would definitely put them on your Christmas list and get them ASAP because they're flawless. Anyway, as you can see, I have very much spoiled myself and I'm now going to be spending the rest of my money on other people, I promise. But yeah, I just thought, seeing as I had picked up so much recently, I thought I would share it with you. I am thinking about doing a Christmas gift guide video type thing. Let me know if that is something that you'd like to see from me. It's not just going to be for girls, it's going to be for mums, dads, brothers, boyfriends and all that jazz. But I might actually make it a post rather than a video. I'm still having to think about it. Anyway, thanks so much for watching and I shall see you soon. Bye guys! Hi guys and welcome back to my channel and welcome to my November favourite.